the Star Wars Fans on FlyGuy.net review. This time, Blu-rays. I know it's taken me a little bit longer to get round to these than everyone else, but I only managed to get them last week, shipped from Amazon in the USA. Now, obviously, I live in Australia, if you watch and know this channel, and you know much about me. But the price of these here for us was around about $120, which is a little bit expensive when I could get these shipped to me for about $80. So I just held off, figured I knew the movies and I knew the plot, so I could wait literally 10 days extra. And that's what I did. So I managed to save myself some bucks, and this is what we got. So shipped from Amazon.com, $80, and it's a beautiful 9-disc set. If you haven't picked these up, I understand obviously some of you might not have Blu-ray players, but there's a list of some of the features and some of the bits and pieces in it. Principally, it's all the movies that we know, so you're getting the 6 episodes, the prequels and the original trilogy. It's the last 2 discs that really make the difference, all these in-depth documentaries. And let's face it, you're probably really here for the deleted scenes all in. But just give you a look at the packaging and the box set itself. Now, it varies slightly from country to country. One thing about the Australia that I'm not a huge fan of is we get a massive piece which goes over there, which gives it a PG rating and kind of covers over a lot of the artwork. This is just the original cellophane and a sticker, but it allows the US editions allow them to be kind of don't have that kind of rating marked on them, so you get to see a little bit more of the artwork as it's originally intended. Now, I'm not a huge fan of this artwork at all. If you follow us on our Facebook page, facebook.com/flyguy.net, we've talked about this. We've talked about it on our podcast, Boring Conversation Anyway, with SithLord229 and many others. It doesn't do it for me, but if it does it for you, there you go. There's a look at the artwork anyway. And inside, it does fold out to be this very cool kind of cardboard thick booklet. So just looking at some of the artwork. Now, a lot of this seems to be from the Visions book, which we discussed again on our blog and Facebook site many, many moons ago, but there's a cool picture of Maul. Now, one thing to note just before I go on any more is the discs here, let me just take one out to give you, show you, the USA discs are not printed. They just have a simple, well, they are printed, but they just have a simple episode one, as you can see. There's no artwork itself. If you go to our Facebook page and look at our photo gallery, all the high-res photographs there will show you the variations in the UK, the Japanese, and the European versions all have printed covers. Same for the Australian ones as well. For some reason, the USA versions just have a blank, kind of fairly blank disc. That's not something that bothers me. This thing's going to spend its life basically inside this booklet, or inside the Blu-ray player, so not going to bother me. But if you really want to get the best looking package, it's often worth just waiting just that little bit longer. Some very cool artwork there on Attack of the Clones of Padme and Anakin Skywalker at that Italian location they filmed it in. It looks pretty beautiful. Again, really good artwork there. Next one inside, I'm going to drop this in a second, is some artwork again for Anakin, and again from Revenge of the Sith, just again back in that from the film. Some very cool kind of stylized artwork done on top of original photography of the scene from A New Hope. Flipping over, we've got Yoda again. Some really cool artwork there. I still like that from Empire Strikes Back. And again, all the movies and the discs. And then we go on to Return of the Jedi. Again, some cool artwork. This is where it kind of falls apart for me. I'm not a huge fan of this Boba, unfortunately, on I can't remember the animal's name, but it appeared in Revenge of the Sith. The Obi-Wan rides on it. Look, it's kind of cool. If you were lucky enough to buy this in Walmart in the USA, you could pick that up as a poster. It was also available in the US if you're still lucky enough to buy it. There was a lithograph set which came with it. Best Buy had, I think, a t-shirt, and a few other stores around the world, different offerings for the movies. Probably the worst artwork, I have to say, is Han here with the Ewoks. Not loving that scene, I have to say, but again, this is a Blu-ray box set. It's going to sit inside. I'm not going to be displaying it out there for all. It's a really unusual and very kind of cool retro, almost like cowboys, sci-fi, cowboys and aliens artwork there from, I have no idea where. I think this is, again, in the Visions book. But nice to see it. There's some guy riding a giant squirrel that looks a bit with a cowboy hat. R2 and 3PO in a kind of silver cork, which I have no idea what's going on there, but if you know, leave a comment below or on Facebook. And finally, the best shot there, I think, probably seen there, it is just all the kind of characters from all the movies there. Boba, Jango, Anakin, some Utapau clones, 3PO and all the others. And this leads us to the booklet, which is inside, and there's no more content in there. One of the discs is in my Blu-ray player already, in case you wonder what's going on. Again, just a little bit more on the movies themselves, giving you a breakdown of all the features inside the movies, giving you a list of all the extended scenes. And by God, this thing has a lot of deleted scenes. I think it's close to an hour's worth of deleted scenes. Really old stuff that we've seen or probably seen that hinted at on YouTube and many other places over the years. We get to see the Wampa scene from Empire Strikes Back, extended Tatooine scenes, some grainy and in black and white. We get to see a little bit of Han Solo's girlfriend from the cantina. Really buying this for the deleted scenes, I have to say. There's a list of some of the special features and documentaries. Again, we've seen a lot of these on different discs or on different releases over the years. One of the new ones is A Conversation with the Masters, which is a very good in-depth Empire kind of review there with the late awesome Irvin Keshner. Star Wars spoofs, a little bit of a YouTube clip show, basically showing you some very cool clips from Weird Al Yankovic to How I Met Your Mother and Robot Chicken, very heavy on the Robot Chicken actually, and all sorts of other features themselves. Again, just some titles, and that is your whack. Now, do you want to buy these movies? I think you should. Certainly, they're the best quality I've seen of these films in all my time, certainly. Anyway, there is a bit of a problem on some of them. Some don't hold up too well in terms of the digital experience and the remastering. So, some of them, for example, Return of the Jedi turns out to be a little bit weird on some of the picture quality. I don't know whether it's some of the CGI or what, but it's it changes its brightness, it changes its kind of saturation in the colour. I'm being a bit of a cinephobe here, but it does look a little bit weird. To me, certainly, Empire looks really crisp and fresh. Maybe it's the Hoth scenes there, and Revenge of the Sith looks pretty good as well. Probably just because it's one of the last movies with the digital effects. But I have to say, A New Hope and The Phantom Menace. The Phantom Menace possibly looks the worst to me. I don't know why. Maybe just because of the older CGI effects. And unfortunately, the Blu-ray shows up a lot of the qualities in A New Hope that you just perhaps didn't want to see. But some of the older prequels with the latest digital animation show it up just a little bit better. Attack of the Clones looks pretty good. Although weirdly sound for me was a bit of an issue in some areas in that movie. But again, I'm being really picky. And you should just go and buy these things. You'll probably find a lot of people have bought them, watched them, and these will be on sale secondhand somewhere. Or you could just forgo the extra features and just buy the movies for a much cheaper price. But I have to say, it's the extra special features, and particularly the deleted scenes, which really are the key feature here. Again, if you're buying them from the USA, if you're in any other country outside of the USA, the cool factor is these are region free, so you can buy them and play them in any PlayStation 3 machine, and it won't region lock you out, which is the way all Blu-rays should be, and not lock you out of the region. You can choose to buy where you want and save some money. So there we go. Look, apart from show you the movies, which I can't, unfortunately, due to licensing on here, so go and buy them. Great sets. And let us know what you think. Did you buy them? What did you like best on the disc? Let us know. Comments below, or as usual, on facebook.com/flyguy.net. More reviews coming up soon. Cheers.